Scientists say a type of bird flu, H3N8, is responsible for the death of more than 160 harbor seals on the East Coast. Reports of sick seals began in September, which coincided with the reports of diseased seals in Alaska's northern coasts. KNOM's Lorelei Kanin reports there is no relation between the avian flu on the East Coast and the disease affecting ice seals and walrus in Alaska.
Rafaela Stimmelmeyer is a research biologist for the North Slope Department of Wildlife Management. She's also the on-site coordinator for the unusual mortality event on ice seals and Pacific walrus in Alaska, and says from the beginning she's worked closely with the investigative teams working on the New England harbor seal cases. She says the bird flu that killed the New England harbor seals is not what is killing seals in Alaska.
The Yumi seals on the Alaska side were actually tested for that early on to rule out that there was no relationship between the East Coast unusual mortality event and the Alaska unusual mortality event.
The New England harbor seals displayed skin lesions and had severe pneumonia and were found along the coast from Maine to Massachusetts. Stimmelmeyer says while there are similarities between the illnesses, like skin lesions on the flippers, there are also differences.
They did not show any of the facial lesions that we would be seeing or the lesions around the snout. These seals over there actually had fulminant pneumonias, and that's actually what we have not seen in our seals.
Researchers are still trying to figure out what's making the seals and walrus sick in Alaska. Stimmelmeyer says they're currently working on ruling out viruses and other causes for the illness.
We don't have a smoking gun right now. I think based on hunter observation, it is a new disease syndrome that we were observing, because based on traditional knowledge as well as communication from the hunters, they had never seen anything like this before.
And the researchers have not ruled out the radionuclei dispersed from the Fukushima nuclear accident as the cause. While a qualitative screening was done early on that told researchers that the diseased seals in Alaska were not carrying large loads of radionuclides, it's not enough to rule radiation out. Stimmelmeyer says they are now looking at whether the diseased seals carried cesium-134 and 137. Cesium-137 is and has been present in the environment throughout the world from nuclear testing done in the 1960s and 70s. Cesium-134 is the signature radionuclide that was released during the Fukushima accident.
We do not think at this point that it is, related to that. But I think one truly has to wait until we have the quantitative numbers to be able to say, no, there is no trace in these animals. And then we confidently can say there is no relationship.
And regarding the Alaska unusual mortality event on ice seals and Pacific walrus, Stimmelmeyer says they have not observed or seen new cases. As the UME on-site coordinator, she says they should be coming out with a regional update in mid-August. Diseased seals in Alaska were first reported last summer. The research for the New England UME on harbor seals was published in the journal M. Bio. Reporting in Nome, I'm Lorelei Kinnean.